हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन कंटिन्यूएशन विद द प्रीवियस वीडियो इन विच वी हैव कवर्ड ऑर्डिनरी हकाबेक. सो ऑलरेडी आई एक्सप्लेन हाउ वी कंस्ट्रक्ट द डिज़ाइन ड्राफ्ट डेंटिंग प्लान एंड लिफ्टिंग प्लान फॉर 10x6 ऑर्डिनरी हकाबेक. इन द सिमिलर मैनर वी कैन कंस्ट्रक्ट ऑर्डिनरी हकाबेक इन 10x10 विच इज इंडिकेटेड हियर. सो हियर वी हैव डिवाइडेड द रिपीट इन टू 4 इक्वल पार्ट्स. So we are getting 4 quarters of 5x5 in the size of 10x10. So in the first and third diametrically opposite quarters, we have indicated the motif in the same manner. So it is a leaving one peak continuous float, leaving one peak continuous float, maximum float, and here again leaving one. Here also warpwise, if you see, after one end, continuous float of 5, continuous float of 5. Similarly in this, so the similar manner we have indicated the motif, and then in the remaining area we have indicated the plane weave, so that in such a manner that it is fitting with the already inserted mark of floating weave. In this way we can complete ordinary hakabek in 10x10. In the similar manner you can construct the draft, denting plan and lifting plan as we have taken for 10x6. Now here we are taking how we modify these designs. So first modification I am taking, we are modifying 10x6. So 10x6, how, by taking 10x6 as the base, how we can modify it? So the first part, the motif will be indicated as it is, and I have already mentioned in modified hakabek we are increasing the areas of floating weave, and automatically the areas of plane weave will get reduced. So here I will indicate 4 motifs within the same refit. So how it can be indicated? For that I have started this with the first end. Now I will start the second, in the next part, the motif with the second end in this manner, a float of 5, and on the second end of this motif, float of 3 and float of 3. So you can see same motif is indicated, just leaving one end. Similarly here, leaving one peak, I will indicate the same motif. Try to understand it. It is little bit subtle part. So I have indicated the longest float, and then on the second end of the motif and fourth end of the motif, I'm taking longer float. And then next motif can be indicated in this area where we have 2 peaks. Third peak can be added from the bottom because it will come in the next repeat over this. So this 4 and 1 from this side will become 5. So here 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 longer float. On second again, 1 below and 1 above longer float. And on fourth, 1 below and 1 above. So this will become another motif. So 1, 2, 3 and 4 motifs will be there. And in the remaining areas, now indicate the plane if it is some remaining area there. So 1 down, 1 up, 1 down, it is missed. It can be indicated here, then it is complete. Then similarly here, 1 down, 1 up, 1 down, 1 up, 1 down, 1 up. And now you can see the view consists of floating areas as well as plane view, but areas of floating view has increased, and that's why this will give more moisture pickup, but firmness will be decreased. Similarly, this 10x10 can be modified, but for modification of this 10x10, we are taking a reversible type of design, and to produce a reversible design we decrease the number of peaks by 2. By 2 means if ends are 10, then peaks will be 8, or if you are taking 8 ends, then peaks will be 10. So I am taking 10x8, and how it can be modified. For this I have made already some sections. So first, same motif will be indicated in 5x5. Reversible means both the sides look similar. So we are going to produce such a modification in which both sides of the fabric will be similar. So to produce reversible, we have taken a size 10x8, and the same motif which we have taken for ordinary we have indicated in the first quarter. But here now we have this remaining quarter. In this we have 5 vertical spaces, but we have only 3 horizontal spaces. remaining 3 horizontal and 5 vertical. So we have a quarter of 5 × 3, which is of lesser size. So what will we do? I will increase this up to the next peak, so it will become 4, and up to the next peak or the above side, so it will be here. So this is there. So I have indicated by dashes. So this is 5 × 4, and 1 will be added, so it will become 5 × 5. So now we have 5 × 5, and because we are constructing reversible haka bag, so this will, these marks, this motif will be reversed. Reverse means here the blank, so it will start with cross, then blank, then cross, then blank, and then cross. And here 5 crosses, so 5 will remain blank. Similarly here, one up, then one up, and then one up. Similarly here in this motif, one up, and one up. So this is just opposite of this one, and we have indicated there, we have replaced the marks with blanks and blanks with marks. So here float of 5 of weft. And now in the remaining, we will indicate the plane view, which should fit with the previously indicated mark. So this is one down, one up, one down, one up. So in this way, you will indicate the plane view. Similarly, in the in this remaining area, here plane, plane. So plane marks will be indicated in the remaining areas, and this will be a 10 × 8 modified reversible haka bag. So we have taken so far two examples of ordinary in 10 × 6 and 10 × 10, and this is 10 × 6 is modified again into 10 × 6 in a different manner, and here we have taken example of modified but reversible. So how a reversible haka bag can be constructed, that you can see here. And if we go for larger size of haka bag, generally like 18 × 18 or 20 × 20, the slot sizes will increase very high, and those designs are known as honeycomb haka bag. So honeycomb haka bag can be constructed in larger sizes like 18 × 18 or more than this. So this is all about haka bag and modified haka bag designs. Thank you.